this is going to be just a little quick video. Well, quick to me. For those Sioux Falls drivers, either Lyft or Uber, if you plan on doing both, I don't know, don't care. But if you're a beginner and you're looking to make a, well, part-time money is okay, but if you're looking into doing this full-time, you can pretty much just forget about that. I am a full-time driver, but only temporary, and temporary being means that I've been part-time and full-time twice each, and I'm looking to be part-time a third time, and I will, after that, I will strictly only be part-time. The reason being is that there is, the Sioux Falls market specifically is not, useful enough. Like, literally on the weekends, for the new drivers, you're probably, I mean, if you're brand new, you're probably going to make a decent amount of income. I would say between 100 and maybe 200. Why is this? Okay. But that's only because you are new. The thing that the Lyft and Uber platform do is that all new drivers, the system algorithm, it allows you to take the first come, first serve kind of deals. And once you've been on it for about a month, they will give you rewards, do so many rides and so many hours. Typically that's kind of hard to do, but it can be done. But don't expect this. Dang it. Don't. Really. That guy. Anyways, don't expect after a few months to be still making the same amount of income. It's just not gonna happen. I am putting in way too many hours and not enough time with family to make this work. So I am looking forward to having a real full-time job with stable income so that I'm not spending 10, 12, 13, 14 hours a day on the road for the income that I used to make 6+ months ago. It is not worth it anymore. In the beginning, it's like, holy shit, I'm making a lot of money here. But not really. I mean, the drivers before me that are full-time, only by like an extra maybe 4 months, they were making even twice as much as me. Now they're making absolutely only half the income that they used to in the beginning. Mostly this is because of the fact that Sioux Falls does not restrict the amount of drivers, and they make it so easy to sign up that it's ridiculous. Now, if you're like in Mitchell, or I think it's mostly just Mitchell, but there are other cities in South Dakota that are very much strict that you actually have to obtain what I would consider a rideshare or taxi license to even operate your vehicle as a driver. And typically that runs about $100 a person, and then you're good to go forever, or at least one I think it's once a year kind of a deal, but Sioux Falls doesn't do that, so it's literally you sign up, you wait to be approved with your background check, you get your stickers, and within about 5 days, you're ready to be a driver, and you're ready to take your first ride. It's that simple. And stick to part-time, or at least what you would consider to be part-time. Full-time for me is putting in like 70 plus hours a week. Not worth it. There is no overtime, there is no PTO, there is no benefits, there is no nothing. It is all on you and you alone. Your gas is on your own, insurance is on your own. The only thing that Lyft gives you is per ride money. That's it. Unless there's tips on top of that, but they're also kind of just rare and hard to come by. Of course, that also depends on the fact of personality and the state of mind that your passengers are in, their work day, going through a hard time. Anything can throw their view of you off, and chances are they're going to take out, you're their venting machine. So take that into consideration. Oh. Not sure really where else to go with this other than we are simply oversaturated. That's all there is to it. We have well over 1,000 registered drivers in Sioux Falls, which is not nearly enough customers to cover all those drivers. Now, not to be mistaken that all those 1,000-plus registered drivers are actually out driving, because that's not the case. Generally, people only register and take a first ride or a second ride just to see how it is for them. And then they quit. They don't do it anymore. Then there's, I would say, not quite dedicated drivers, but just the ones that stick around to make enough money to cover a small bill or two. And that's it. Those are just weekend drivers. There's airport drivers. I personally don't really enjoy those. Not the drivers, but the waiting time, because you don't know if you're going to be there in the lot sitting for, you know, 20 minutes, 15 minutes, all the way up to an hour. And the one ride that you get might only be going 5 minutes away or all the way up to, I think it's, we're limited at 4 or 5 hours away. And, yeah. You have no idea where you're going, so. Now for me, the longest ride I've taken is from the Sioux Falls Airport, not in queue, to the Minneapolis Airport. And this was at, like, roughly 1:30 in the morning. And I got 2 and from in under, just under 8 hours. There was no breaks. I didn't take any. No need for them. I'm just that kind of a driver, I guess, but long rides are very hard to come by. In city, long rides are like anything over 10 minutes. And it used to be that your typical $10 ride was amazing. Nowadays, your typical $10 ride is no longer $10. It's only about, you get like 8 out of it. And that's if they tip you. So Lyft and Uber have slightly raised customers' what they're paying. Basically, the customer pays the same, but on our end, we didn't get a raise. We got a cut so that they could make more profit. Now, you would think that, yes, we are contractors, but we don't get to decide how much we make. That's not how it works. It's basically like a subcontract, I would consider it to be. You're not in control of how much money you make. You're on their platform making what they want you to make. And it's up to how many rides you take that allows you to make your income. And so don't expect a lot of money if you're going like 5 minutes or a few blocks away. You're going to be making $2.55 off of that ride. And that's if they tip you. Most of the time, they do not. Again, that just depends on the passenger specific that you get. There's some people that are high tippers. And that's like a very high chance, okay, a very low chance of you getting that. Most of the time, that's just random people. There's definitely people around here in Sioux Falls that have their specific clientele and are devoted to giving those specific people rides. And do I know who they are? I do not. I just know what's happening. If you're, you know who you are. I don't know who you are, but it happens. It's going to continue to happen. That's the only way sometimes that some people make the income that they're looking for. And I'm almost going on 15 minutes here, and I was not expecting that, but I think I mostly got my point across, so there's that. I guess he's done cleaning himself. Alright. I guess I'm gonna go out and start driving for the day. Not gonna make the money that I need to make. And I'm gonna be spending too much time doing it. Looking forward to that full-time new job.